growing up, I was always known as Ariana the church girl. I mean, both of my parents were ministers, and everyone thought I was so perfect. But least did they know, even though I was in the church, I wasn't really in the church. All I really cared about were the latest fashions, sports, and college. Before I went off to school, I made a few promises to myself. I promised that I would never drink or smoke, that I would stay a virgin till I was married, but I kind of messed that up before I left, and that I would always go to church every Sunday morning because I knew it was the right thing to do. This guy named Marcus helped me move in. He was kind of cute. I think I might talk to him. And I also met this guy named Jerome. He was also a church boy. And he always tried to get me to go with him on Sundays. And I always came up with an excuse not to go. I kind of wish that I didn't. You'll know what I mean. Just watch. As you can see, I've been spending way too much time with that guy Marcus, the one that helped me move in. I've had to come up with so many excuses not to go to church with Jerome. I told my best friend Darnell all about it. He told me just to cut Marcus off, so I did. Thank you.
That's bro.
This is
him later. What's up, man? You all right?
Yeah.
What's good, old good. How you doing? Good. You trying to dance?
Hey, turn up, hey,
bro. Come on,
Leon. Dang, bro. Why y'all be lame, bro?
Yeah. So, that was Leon.
Dog, that food was so good.
It
was
good.
That food was good. Like, I should have carried y'all, like, for real.
I know you should have, for real. Because I was definitely tired of that food.
Got some of them biscuits.
With the cinnamon butter?
Tell them.
No, but I meant to ask y'all. Have y'all heard this new song by Jonathan Reynolds called No Gray?
Yes,
yeah, it's
my
good,
friend
man.
Listened to it a while back. It is so real though. Like I love it.
Like real talk.
So what's it about though?
Just listen.
Okay.
I'm split in two. Part of me loves the world, and the other loves you. So. What do I do?
Ooh,
I wanna be safe, but
bruh,
I gotta
be like
stay
that
cool.
Sometimes.
Can you shut this off?
No, I'm not a fool.
What's wrong with you?
I just don't like the song. Can you please just shut it off?
Really,
okay.
You know what'd be funny?
What? I really feel that God will pull you to ministry. Like He is calling you to do something with your life.
Anyways, that's not funny. Can we please just shut up and keep it moving? Turn that new TI back on.
What?
Plus, it's really none of your business. So if you want to remain friends, I suggest you just stop talking.
Well, I was just...
You were just minding your business.
Whatever.
Really?
December 11th, 2010. When I was running up and down that hallway, I experienced one of the most craziest things of my life. I heard a strange voice that told me to run, and I couldn't control myself. It showed me things of my past that I was not happy about. I was afraid of being alone, and I did things I promised I wouldn't. As I was running, it felt like demons were after me, and trying to pull me and tell me where they were is where I belonged. I didn't know what else to do but to fall to my knees and call on the Lord. I yelled at the top of my lungs, "Jesus, whatever it is you're trying to tell me, I'm listening. Whatever it is that you need me to do, I'll do it." Then I snapped out of it. I looked up with tears in my eyes while everyone huddled around me. They were asking me, was I okay? And I told them that there was something God was trying to tell us. As I walked and stood in the study room, I began to see gold letters on the window. I started to read out loud to everyone what God was saying, and it left us all in an awe. I felt the enemy trying to pull me back, so I told everyone to begin to pray. When I passed out, I could hear the enemy saying, "Don't believe that mess." And I spoke back and said, "Well, it's too late. I already know who I serve, and that's Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior." And as soon as I said that, I could feel a huge shift. It felt like God Himself stepped in and knocked the enemy out of the way. All I could hear now was, "Sing praises unto me." When I woke up in the hospital, they told me that I was unresponsive for a few minutes, but as soon as everyone prayed, I was fine. I couldn't help but smile. Then they also mentioned how I was paralyzed from the neck down. I kept telling them that the Lord was going to bring me out of it, and how that was the day that God was making me new. They kept running tests and trying to figure out why my friends and I kept saying that we did have alcohol and smoke before we came, because they couldn't find it in my system. Needless to say, I walked out of the hospital the next day clean, literally. I couldn't wait to tell Darnell and Leon what happened. Darnell thought I was crazy, but he continued to be my friend. It was time to go home from winter break, and I wanted so much more of Jesus, I can't even explain. My desire to want more of Him grew more and more each day. But then I began to have dreams and visions, and I didn't quite understand what was going on. As time went by, my friends and I became accountable for each other, and would even get together and have Bible studies. I shared with them how I was having dreams and visions, then seeing them being manifested, but didn't really understand. I didn't know why people wanted to hang with me, talk to me, or pray with them. I didn't think I was even qualified because God was just getting my life together. Until one day, we went to this campus crusade that opened my eyes, our eyes, and confirmed so much for us. Christ showed us that it doesn't matter how young or old we are, He can use us with what we have, and that He would continue to build us up along the way. That we aren't called to be normal, but we're called to be uncommon people.